So we can all agree that Lightroom is a seriously powerful photo management, editing, and sharing platform, right? But here's the thing. When developers build apps like Lightroom, they have to find a balance between surfacing the most important tools that you need for your photos and not overwhelming you by displaying a seemingly never-ending list of panels, sliders, and checkboxes. So some of those tools get hidden behind secret shortcuts and submenus and preference screens. The thing is that these hidden tools can actually make a big difference in how you use apps like Lightroom, and it can improve your overall experience with it. Now, I've already shared a video covering 7 of my favorite hidden tricks in Lightroom Desktop, and I'll link to that at the end of this video. But for this particular video, I'm gonna share 5 more tricks that you may not know about, but you should. So let's dive in. Okay, so before we start anything, you will see that I have my version of Lightroom open here, and you might be wondering, why doesn't this look like my version of Lightroom? That's because I use Lightroom's cloud-based ecosystem. So I use Lightroom Desktop and Lightroom Mobile for my iPhone and my iPad. If your Lightroom doesn't look like mine on your computer, that's because you're probably using Lightroom Classic. And while the stuff that I show you here, a lot of it will work in Lightroom Classic, my focus in all of my educational videos here on YouTube, as well as my courses that I sell on my website, are all focused on Lightroom's cloud-based ecosystem. And so I just wanted to bring that up to avoid any confusion you might have. Okay, so the first hidden trick that I want to show you has to do with how you access your photos. So the way Lightroom works is you organize photos by folders and by albums. So you can have a folder, and then under the folder, you can have more folders. And then under those folders, you can have albums. So let's say you can see how when I expand 2016, you can see each of the months that I have. And that's how I organize my folders. I go by year, then by month, and then by the shoot itself, by the individual day. But let's say I wanted to see all of the albums and subfolders here under 2016. Well, if I collapse this and then I press and hold on the command key or the control key if you're on Windows and then click, you see how now all of the folders and subfolders are expanded. So it's just an easy way to get access to all of your subfolders. Now, if you press Command or Control and then click again, and then click without pressing Command or Control, you'll see there are all of the subfolders. So again, Command or Control click will expand all of the subfolders and albums. So it's just a convenient way for you to see all of the photos under a given folder. Now for the second tip, this one also gets overlooked pretty easily, and it has to do with the background of the kind of the active preview area when you're either reviewing a photo or editing it. And the reason why it's overlooked is because a lot of people don't realize that you can right click anywhere over here and you can see this menu pops up and it shows the background color. Now I admittedly use the dark gray, which is the default, but a lot of times depending on the lighting conditions of the room you're in, you might want to select black. It'll just add more contrast and it'll sometimes make editing the photo easier on your eyes. But there's another kind of useful color here, and that is white. And the reason why I say white is because a lot of times when we go to print our photos, often when we put the photo in the frame, there's usually a matte and that matte is generally white. So what you can do here is by selecting white as your background color, you can go and change your zoom factor to something like 25. And this gives you a nice preview of what that photo would look like inside a matte. Now you can press the tab key to hide both the left and right panels. So you can get kind of a full screen view. And then if you want, we can go ahead and zoom a little bit more. Again, to get an idea of what the photo would look like in the matte. I'll go ahead and press the tab key to bring my panels back. I'll right click and go back to dark gray. But again, that's just something that I wanted to show you because it gets overlooked and it's one of those little quality of life improvements that I think are worth at least knowing about. All right, so for tip number 3, it actually has to do with the left and right panels. So really quickly, Lightroom is broken down primarily into left and right panels. On the left, that's kind of your photo management area. And on the right, that's where you'll have all of your editing tools. And there are keyboard shortcuts to access both of those panels. To access the photos panel on the left, you can just press the P key and that will show and hide that panel. And then you can also press the E key to show the editing panel. And so it's easy to remember because P is for photos and E is for editing. But what if you want to only have one panel showing at any given time? So for example, if you're in your edit panel, You want to maximize your screen real estate automatically without having to press the P key to hide that. Well, if you go to the preferences over here in Lightroom, and then go to the interface tab over here, you'll see a dropdown for panel tracks. And I have it set to manual, which shows here that the panel tracks must be manually opened or closed. If I change this to automatic and then click on the blue done button, watch what happens when I first press E to hide the edit panel. So now you can see I have the photos panel. Then when I press E again to enable the edit panel, you see how the photos panel hid itself by default. This is great, again, if you're working with a monitor that isn't too big or you're using a lower resolution and you want to maximize your screen real estate. So here, when I press P to go to the Photos tab, you see how the edit panel on the right was hidden. So again, it just automatically toggles open the left and right panels depending on what you're doing. So generally, if you are in your Photos view, you're going to look for a specific album to either share or edit a photo. And then when you press E to edit the photo, you want to focus on that photo so you can hide the photo navigator. Now I prefer having that done manually, so I'm going to go over here to preferences and then I'm going to change this back to manual and click done so that I can have both of the panels open at the same time. Now my fourth tip also has to do with panels, but they're specifically focused on the editing panel on the right. Now it's understandable that if you were to scroll down and you look at all of the different tools that you have at your disposal in Lightroom to get overwhelmed. I totally get that. But there is a great way to kind of simplify that and make your editing workflow more enjoyable. And you'll find that by going to this ellipse right over here. It's under the versions icon. We're going to click on this and then we're going to click on single panel mode. When you do that, you'll see that now all of the other panels have automatically collapsed. We only have the light panel open. Now watch what happens when I go to color. You see how light has been collapsed and only color is open. And this can be helpful if you have a specific order in which you work. So let's say you want to start editing your tones. You can expand that. And then when you're done with editing your tones, you can go to color over here, edit color, and then you can move on to effects, which has things like clarity and dehaze, for example, as well as your vignette. And then you can finalize things with detail and optics, as well as lens blur. The point is that in the single panel mode, only one panel will be open at any given time, and that will help simplify things and will prevent getting overwhelmed, especially if you're new to Lightroom. Now, to disengage it, all you need to do is repeat the process by clicking on the ellipse and then deselecting single panel mode. Okay, so for the fifth and final tip in this video, this has to do with cropping. And there is this option here that gets overlooked so easily. And actually what I'm gonna do is press P so we can see this even larger. And that has to do with the overlay that is displayed when you crop. By default, we're always told that, you know, you should compose using the rule of thirds, and that makes total sense. And it's helpful when you have that overlay here in the crop mode. But did you know that you have a bunch of other helpful crop modes here? So this crop overlay dropdown, when you click on it, you have all of these other options. And if you hover over them, you'll see previews. So this is kind of a finer grid view. Then we have our thirds. You also have fifths. You have diagonal. So this is great, especially for kind of architecture shots. This helps a lot. Here you have center. So if your subject is center weighted and you want to make sure that they are actually in the center, this is a great overlay. You got triangles, golden ratio, golden spiral, which is also one of my favorites, especially if you want to position your subject around the area where the spiral gets tighter. And then finally, one of the most underrated but also supremely helpful ones, especially if you print, is aspect ratios. So here you can take the guesswork out of whether you go to print a 5x7 or a 4x6 photo, whether everything that you want is going to be within the confines of that paper. You also have 2x3 and 4x5. And of course, when you click over here and you press the X key, and this works in any mode, if you press the X key, it'll shift from horizontal to vertical. So here you can now see what the aspect ratios are like in a vertical print. Pressing X again will go to horizontal. And then you can click on this, this button right here to reset that so it goes to full screen. So again, for me, I generally stick with thirds by default, but don't sleep on these other options here because they're really helpful when you want to achieve a specific crop or composition. All right, so those are five of my additional favorite tricks in Lightroom. And here's the thing. If this kind of got you really excited about Lightroom and what is involved with Lightroom desktop and mobile, then please check out my course called Lightroom Everywhere. I'll link to it in the description below. It's got over 9 hours of easy paced lessons that teach you absolutely everything that you'd need to know about using Lightroom desktop and mobile. I guarantee you there is no other course out there that dives as comprehensively into the cloud-based ecosystem of Lightroom as Lightroom Everywhere. So again, the link is in the description below. I thank you for checking that out. I mentioned that I already shared a video with 7 other hidden tricks in Lightroom desktop, so check that out over here. And if you found this video helpful, please click the thumbs up button and be sure to subscribe and click on the bell icon to get notified of all future videos. Thanks a lot, everyone.